Friends, welcome back. In the previous couple of videos that I have uploaded, I have clearly indicated the usage of Realsense and I have shown you a small demo. But I didn't explain you the procedure where you can install Realsense step by step in your laptop or your desktop. So I'm going to just show you the procedure as well as I'm going to tell you how exactly you can carry out the installation procedure. And I will also explain the options that are available with Realsense so that you can understand how exactly you can use it for your experiments and research. Now, you need to first go to the realsense.intelrealsense/get-started. There, they have the details clearly about all the types of cameras that they have under the Realsense category. They have two cameras actually, two series actually. One is D400 series, another one is T265 series. What I have in hand is D415 series. This is the camera, whatever I have shown you yesterday. And if you want to read more about it, you need to just go ahead and click start. Once you click that, you will be connected to an appropriate link where you have more details about this particular camera, where they have also explained how exactly the each and every component are to be connected, what is the procedure, all this I have explained you clearly. Now, what is the next step to be done? The next step to be done is to download the clear installables, I mean the SDKs and the viewers, all those things for you. So where do we go ahead and download it? So you need to go to the software.intel.com/enus/realsense/d400-get-started. In that page, if you see, connect the depth camera. That's the first step. We have connected it and I have shown you that yesterday. Now, installation of the Realsense SDK and the Realsense viewer is the only step that we will have to do right now to get this up and running. I mean it again, we need to get this up and running. So how do we do it? Very simple. We need to download just the Realsense SDK and the Realsense viewer. So how do we go ahead about it? We use Windows now and we have Linux link also, which I will teach you a little later, not now. So I have got a Windows link here and go to the GitHub page. So I have to open the GitHub page and I have the GitHub link already available with me. Now, if you see this, they have got a very clear documentation and they have given the supporter platforms as Ubuntu, Windows 10, Windows 8.1, 7, Mac OS and appreciably Android 7 and 8 as well. The complete series of D400 is all supported. What I have in hand is D415. So this is sufficient for us to really work further and complete our research. Now, the supporter languages are really a plenty. Really, really, so many platforms are supported, so many languages are supported, C++, Python, Node.js, C, LabVIEW, Unity. Unity is most preferred for VR, AR applications and we are going to see a lot more with Unity in near future. And MATLAB, OpenNative, Unreal, all these are supported and here they have given the assets detail and you got to download all these. Not all these, actually you need to download the SDK for Windows 10, which is 507 MB here, and then the Realsense viewer. The moment you download it, you get something like this, where you can see that I have got Realsense SDK for Windows 10. I'm going to install it right now, and Realsense viewer is something which is very simple, which I'll tell you later what it is. Now I have just started my installation procedure. It takes few minutes maximum, maybe about 1 or 2 minutes is what we need. Once it is done, we are all set to go. But only thing that I want you to confirm is if your Realsense camera is detected properly. If it is not detected properly, you need to really check the connections and make sure that the Realsense is detected and you get a proper indication saying that the Realsense is set up for Windows for you to use it right now. Without that, things don't work fine. And for you to run the available examples already, I'm going to teach you that also a little later. And to modify them, it will be very easy and interesting. So I'm going to show you that in the near future, but for that, all these are to be done. One thing that you need to remember is we are not easily getting Realsense in India. So if you have some friends in US or in Europe, you can easily get it. And in India, it is a bit tough to import it right now. Maybe in near future, it will be available in India. So you can see that the installation is pretty fast. And what I have is a i7 8th gen with NVIDIA GeForce configuration available with me and I have 12 GB RAM with me. Right, now it is all done. So you should see that we have got the Realsense viewer launched and Realsense D415 is detected. What we need to do is I need to just switch on the stereo module. So you can see that the images are right available in front of you. Now I'm going to switch on the RGB camera also. So in this RGB camera, you can see that I'm talking right now, and in parallel you are getting my stereo module depth stream is available in front of you. So I've got my camera in parallel, so I cannot show you that in this video because I'm recording it through a screen recorder right now. Now what we are going to do is I'm going to show you the 3D space right now. Now you can see that the beautiful part is you can see even the top view of it. You can see that the top view of it is also seen, and real time even my lip sync is properly done. You can see that here the lip sync is absolutely proper, and I'm coming close to that. I'm going out of the view of camera right now, so you can see the way it is going off. Now I'm coming closer to the camera view. So that is how things work here. This is XYZ for the depth image. Now we are going to try out all the options one by one. That's most important, right? I didn't show you that options last day. So I'm going to show you these options one by one, and let's really understand how things work. So exposure, I'm going to increase the exposure to somewhere around 86,000 right now. No major changes seen, but you can see now when we reduce what happens. So I've reduced it to 12,000. The content is getting, here you can see the depth content is getting varied. So I'm going to make it to default 37,000. I have made it. Now the gain I'm increasing, you can see that the gain is increased. Here you can see that the changes are happening in this sector. So the gain, I'm going to keep it normal as say around 50. Now the laser power, I'm increasing the laser power view. Not much changes are seen visually, but I think there should be an impact. And ASIC temperature, this should make an impact. We will see how exactly it works. So projector temperature and the projector temperature and the ASIC temperature are fixed, which means the current projector temperature is what they are showing, and you are not permitted to adjust it, which means the current temperature that the Realsense is projecting on me is what is shown there. So the depth unit is also presented here, and you can see that it's quickly changing. You can see that how close it is changing in the right hand side, and now I am reducing it. So you could see that immediately. You can see now you will see the number of layers in the image. I mean the depth construction happens this way. So you see that now it is much better. Now the stereo baseline, again you can enable the timestamp. Advanced controls are there where you can control the depth. You can go ahead with the neighbor threshold, median threshold, estimate median increment. All these are purely mathematical, and you can try it out. And we have got RSM, we have got RAU, we've got all these supported. I'm going to read it out. Color, SLO, SLO penalty control, HTAD, color correction, depth table, AE control, all these are available there. And depth visualization is also supported, and dynamic fixed. Now this is fixed screen. You can see that. And near, this is near, and this is far. So we are going with far. Now we are setting it up to dynamic. And color scheme is there, classic. This is classic. Black and white is there. Now this is black and white. And bio is there. This is bio. Cold and quanted and quantized, I'm sorry, pattern. This is pattern, and all these are available real time. You can see that you can get all these updates real time. And most importantly, post processing is something that we need to discuss. So I'm keeping it back to the jet, which is the normal one that is available by default. So the post processing also we have available, where decimation filter, you must have studied about the filters in the digital signal processing, where we have decimation filters available, threshold filter, spatial filter, temporal filter, hole filtering, hole filling filter. All these are supported here, and now I have enabled the hole filling filter. So now you can see that I have disabled it. Now temporal filter I have disabled. You can see the immediate difference. Spatial filter I am disabling. You can see the difference now. I am enabling it. Threshold filter disabled, enabled. There is a minor change that you can immediately see. Decimation filter disabled, enabled. So all these are available real time. And this is all about the Realsense camera and the working. Now we can write code for it to capture all the gestures, to do the robotic applications, to do the applications that can be controlled. I mean, I can use my RealSense to control the drone as well. I can do this, I can do the gesture control to control the drone even. They have got applications in robotics, they have got applications in IoT, they have got applications in AR, VR. I have studied the case study of all this and it's really wonderful and phenomenal. So, I hope you like the session. If you have any queries about the installation or if you have any queries about how to set it up, please reach me out. I'll be more than happy to help you. Thank you very much for following my channel and the content. I'll be coming back to you with new contents and new demos in near future. Thank you.